This is Lori Vallone with Doggone Good Consulting. It's week three in the Power Apps Made It with Power Apps Challenge. And this week we're talking about building applications step by step. So let me take you through my process. First, you need to make sure you really understand the problem. You need to identify a group of stakeholders that can help you define what it is you need to accomplish with your solution. You don't necessarily need to write a book of requirements, but you need to make sure that you very clearly understand what you need the application to do for you. Then you need to plan out your solution. What is the basic functionality that you're going to provide, and how is that intended to work? What information do you need to store, and what actions does the application need to take? Then you're going to need to prepare your data sources, wherever you're going to put this data. For me, that's usually SharePoint, because that's the simplest place that I have access to. But it could be Excel, it could be SQL Server, it could be Azure. Once your data sources are built, then you need to build your core framework. Focus first on the big things, making sure that it writes, making sure that it reads, that you can move from screen to screen. Don't worry about all the little details of making it pretty or getting in all the odds and ends of functionality. Just build the core first and make sure that works. Then test it. Make sure that basic functionality is working. Now you have a framework that you can build the rest of the system on. Next, you're going to want to iterate to augment and add that functionality you didn't put in the first time, and to beautify it. Clean up all of the fonts and colors and make sure things match and have the final look and feel that you want. Then you want to take that app and socialize it with your key stakeholders, the ones you started with when you were understanding the problem. Make sure that you have developed what it is they were looking for. Refine it based on their feedback. Then pilot it with a limited group of users. Polish based on your pilot's results, and then you're ready to launch. That's my step-by-step process for building applications in Power Apps.